scent is quite strong. I wonder where it will take me. It's over now. That ladder. Someone set up camp in here. Looks like a means of transportation to get to that sanctuary. Seems to show two possible courses of action. One means transformation, and the other means death. The panel looks different from the other. It's much more elaborate.
Thank you.
must be my transportation to the sanctuary.
This... Oh my God! Did I almost forget about Harry? She doesn't seem to care much about Harry. And she doesn't seem to be thinking straight either. Harry, that look on your face.
My dear old pal, it's only Cass and me now. I have much to thank her for, even if our friendship is worn thin due to hunger and fatigue. If she hadn't insisted so much, we'd never have convinced Teharoa. He guided us as we followed the river down from the mountain peak. And that's how we found this entrance. And the mural. Maybe I can't undo what's happening to you, Norah, but I think I can try to become like you. The original inhabitants of this island took slaves to a sanctuary, and there they performed a ritual. Teaharoa said the ritual was madness, and he didn't want any part of it. He and Cass argued violently. When we woke up the next morning, he had left. I know it sounds strange, but you have to trust me, my love. I know this is going to work, and we can be together. You understand what that means, don't you, Norah? We have a second chance. With more love than ever, Harry.
Harry? What ritual are you talking about? Why on earth would you want to become like me? Please don't be a fool. You don't even know if that ritual of yours is going to work.
Somebody painted these symbols on the wall. You followed the river from the temple summit, and it took you some days to find this entrance.
A sanctuary? Harry... Oh, dear.
The sun is setting. It is so beautiful.
It all makes sense. Nothing bad is going to happen to me here, as menacing as this place might look. The island, the ooze, those sea creatures. They're just defending themselves, like a wild animal against an unknown threat. That's how they perceived the expedition, like a threat. But I, on the other hand, I wasn't a threat. And I definitely wasn't unknown, was I? They seemed to recognize me, as if I was one of their own. Everything seems so distant now. As if I first stepped on that white beach thousands of years ago. A full moon? It can't be. Yesterday was a new moon. Did I lose track of time, or... Maybe this place isn't subject to the laws of physics. That's the only explanation I can find for this surreal night. It's hard to believe everything is real. Maybe it isn't. Maybe I'll open my eyes sometime and I'll be back in our home in Inglewood and... Everything will be as before. My perfectly ordinary life with Harry. My daily routines. My illness. That will be as before, too. And then I'll need to shake off this strange feeling that I have now. Feeling that I don't really belong there anymore. And with there, I don't mean Englewood. Or Boston, or Newburyport. I mean... How is it possible that the strange events of only 2 days on this island makes more sense to me than the life that I've been living for years? There it is. The sanctuary. So is this where you went, Harry? Was this your last stop? Another camp, although it's little more than a few things scattered about.
My dear old pal, I never should have trusted Cass. I thought she cared about you, but she's just mad, obsessed with this place. I can't trust her to help me overcome the last obstacle. This door, I know how to open it. But what I have to do is mix my blood with the black ooze. Am I mad for even considering that? It's the only way we can be together. It has to work, right? All this can't be a coincidence. The ritual is made for the two of us, isn't it, Norah? I wish you could be here to... Damn it. I have to think it over. I can't. Tomorrow. Leave it for tomorrow, damn it. Stop writing!
What are you saying, Harry? Don't you see what the black ooze does, what it did to the doctor? Are you out of your mind? Was the blood of these creatures... a library? These patterns look too familiar. really hope this works. He's behind that door. I wonder which Harry I'll find. How much would be left of the man I love? And how much of the man who has lost his sanity in this place? An eye and a star. Look at the stars, maybe. Those stones. I wonder what this means. Constellations and stars. These people seem to worship otherworldly gods. They carried these people here to test them, like a challenge of some sort. Where is this door leading me? A shining constellation. I better draw it. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? Circular stones with strange carved symbols. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? An eye and a star. Look at the stars, maybe. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it used for? The stars are aligned, forming a constellation that I don't recognize. That is not the same sky you can see from Earth. And if that's not the Earth sky, where am I now?
It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges. What was it? Used for. Constellations and stars. These people seem to worship otherworldly gods. I wonder what this means. Moby Dick. Its pages are hollowed out, and its shape is... Harry asleep in his... Give it a try.
Ouch! Oh! Ah! What was that?
Looks like a tattoo, but it isn't. Those are my spots. They've moved. Icons on the wheel are the same as the constellations I have on my hand. It's a pentagon-shaped symbol with channels in its edges.
What was it used for?